So let's look at chopping into a wiring loom. It could be PVC tape, it could be cloth tape, but it's pretty much the same for either. What we're going to do is, if you can, hopefully you can see where two cables are next to each other. The idea is we're going to run our knife down the middle of these two cables so we don't cut either of them. So you find a spot where you want to bring your cable into. Let's say in this loom we want to connect a red wire to a thin gauge red wire that's already in there. There's two reds, there's a thicker one and a thinner one, so we've got to make sure we get the right cable. But if you were doing this, you would test it with a multimeter or a test light to make sure we had the right one. So we want to join this into here. First thing, we need to give ourselves some working space, so we find where the cables are lying next to each other, and there's a good long run, and then very, very gently use a sharp knife. Remember, a blunt knife is a dangerous thing, and we just hardly any pressure, just enough to get the tape open. And don't be frightened of giving yourself enough space to work. If you make it too difficult for yourself, that's when problems occur. So there's our red. I believe that's our thin that we're after. And then if we look, there's our fatter one there. See the difference in size. So we get the thin red out. I'm going to give myself a little bit more space. Get the thin red out. I'm going to pull it right out. You can bend the loom, give yourself even more space, you see. Right, now we've got our cable exposed. So we strip our end. Again, I use the middle of the rivet. Gives you plenty just to be able to wrap it round. So that's the cable we're joining onto in our loom. And then in our loom, this is the advantage of automatic strippers. Find a decent place. I'm going to go slightly up. You might have a couple of goes at it. Now this, the insulation on this cable is going to want to sneak back. So this is where you have everything ready. Soldering iron's hot, I'm ready to go. I'll get my new cable, join it together and give it a good twist, nice tight twist, and make sure we've got no straggly ends. Now we're not going to be able to use heat shrink, obviously, because this cable's joined at both ends, so we can't slip it on. So it'll be insulating tape. There we go, that's joined ready for soldering. Clean our soldering tip. Tin it. And then working from the bottom, soldering on the bottom, nice blob of solder. As soon as you see capillary action, drawing it into the copper. Where you go, work across the top, leave it there for a bit. Job done. Now we've got to insulate this joint. If you're working out in the cold, just a little tip, keep your insulating tape in your pocket. Just makes the glue a lot more sticky and the tape a lot more stretchy, because we want to put a bit of stretch over this. So if we start at the top, fold it around nicely, we can then bring it around. I'm putting a little bit of tension on it and then just let it find its own pattern. That's insulated now. Now if we wanted to connect another one, another cable, let's go for this yellow. Don't connect it here, next to this join we've just done. Stagger it, go a little bit higher, a little bit lower. Otherwise what you'll end up with is, when you're insulated, one, you run the risk of them squishing together and shorting out where there's solder in there. But then you end up with this big sort of knot. Whereas if you space it out a little bit, it'll sit, the whole thing will just sit in there better, look nicer. So now we can take this loom up. Start at the top, this is where we cut, so we want to go a little bit above that. And again, just let the tape find its pattern. A little bit of tension over it. I'm holding it with my right hand, keeping them bunched together. Bring it down, and then if we were bringing this loom out, our new wire, we go past the join, and if this was going off in that direction over towards our accessory, we could bring the wire out, go past it, carry on until we've gone past where we cut this loom open. So is about there. Let's go maybe an inch past it, a couple of inches, and then snap that tape off. Now that loom's back to how it was, more or less where we started. Now just to finish this off, definitely if you've got more than one cable, but I always do it, even if it's a single cable, I think it just looks a little bit nicer, a bit neater. Bring this in, and then we just take this wire, bring it round, and again I'm holding it with my right hand, trying to keep the cable a bit taut, and just loom it. Like so. There you go, I'll go mad. And I think that just looks a little bit nicer, especially you've got a couple of wires coming out. Hopefully this one's helped you out. Have a look at my other stuff. See you on the next one.